I mentioned to you to watch out for hot water recirc pumps across pressure reducing valves. I said to you, never do it. I can't scream in this, I'll blow your brains out, but if you were in one of my seminars, I'd be pounding the table right now, because I see so many people make this mistake. On a high-rise building, do not take a domestic hot water recirc pump and try to recirculate it across pressure zones, across pressure reducing valves. It will be a problem. So we're back to the World's Fair again, 1983. Same owner, Chris Edmondson, coming to Knoxville again. And I got a phone call, a different hotel. This was a high rise. And they were complaining about, again, it cold in the morning, that a person going to take a shower in certain parts of their hotel couldn't get in hot water. It would take forever to get it. And it's the same owner, same contractor. We fixed the previous one. He says, Chris, if you come back out here, I'll give you another free hotel room in my new, brand new high-rise Hilton Hotel in downtown Knoxville if you try to help me fix this problem. So here I go. I sold the equipment. I'm making friends with a contractor. Why not? So here's a picture of that high-rise Hilton Hotel. The chain, I think the name has been changed to Quality now, but the hotel's still there. It's roughly 20 stories tall, downtown Knoxville. And the exact height, I think that was it. And here's a pipe layout. We got one water heater. The pressure coming in from the pressure boost is 120 pounds. That's the green. Goes to through this water heater, heats the water up for the whole building, rises up to about the 10th floor, which is about 100 feet up, and we're at 70 pounds now, and we go through a pressure-reducing valve. We drop from 70 pounds down to 50, and then the hot water is fed down from that 10th floor, starting at 20, back down to the bottom at 70 pounds, to all the rooms to keep the pressure below 80. Remember, by building code, you can't be over 80 pounds to a fixture. In fact, 80 pounds, in my humble opinion, you don't want to take a shower. You want the water pressure a little bit less than that. 80 pounds is a pretty, pretty hot shower. So in this case, they were trying to hold the pressure to a max of 70 pounds on any fixture. So then on the 10th floor, we kept on going up to the 20th floor, at which time we had a down feed again. And we downfed all the pressures there from 20 back down to 70. So that pressure reducing valve, I hope you recognize on the 10th floor is the problem. Let's see how it's the problem. We've got one recirc pump coming from the top, the red, coming from the D 20 pounds pressure coming down to the very bottom floor. And there we're tying in with the recirc line from the bottom 10 floors to a little B100. There's my little 2 GPM NRF or B100 bronze circulator again. Same circulator is fine. Heat loss is nothing. Heat loss is nothing here. Back to the water heater. So where's the problem? The top 10 floors work fine. The bottom 10 floors, I hope you recognize, is a problem because we got a recirc pump trying to cross that pressure reducing valve that we dropped 50 pounds in. So let's see where the real problem is. Do you see where the 70 pounds blue is going through a check valve into the red? So you telling me that 70 pounds will not flow into 118? No, I don't think it will. I don't think that recirc pump of 70 pounds is going to flow into the 118 down to the recirc pump. So the top 10 floors are recirculating nicely. The top 10 floors are happy. Everybody's got hot water. The bottom 10 floors, they cannot get hot water on a cold day. It's just about impossible to get it there. You get it there, but you're going to have to flow a lot of water down the drain. Before you get water, you got a lot of mad people having to wait that long to get hot water to a shower. So you see the problem again, hopefully, as we cross that pressure reducing valve. And I hope you see from a physical engineering standpoint that 70 pounds of pressure is not going to flow in the 118. So how would you fix the problem? We've got to fix it quickly. So as you see here, I'm just changing back and forth between the slides so you understand the point. You see where the problem is there. I'm going to add a circuit setter or a balancing valve on that return line coming from the top 10 floors. I'm going to take a huge pressure drop across. I'm going to take 52 pounds. And when I take that 52 pounds of drop, I now have the 68 pounds red, where before it was 118, I'm down to 68 now. So now my blue recirc line will flow into my little red recirc line there if that pressure is that low. So everybody see how we can make it? We balanced it. But what a huge penalty in energy cost, what a huge penalty in a pressure drop to make it work. This is how we made it work. Then we take the return line down to the recirc pump. But wait a minute, now my recirc pump has a suction pressure of 68. it's got to get into a water heater at 120 pounds. And that's the problem. So how are we going to do that? Well, my little NRF22 ain't going to work anymore, right? I'm going to have a low flow, high head pump. I got to have a low flow, high head pump. In this case, we actually took two inline series 60s, 2 horsepower each, and put them in series. Put two pumps in series, 4 horsepower total, two pumps, 2 horsepower each, to give me a pump head of 122 feet at 6 GPM to make this thing work. We made it work. But why so much head? Remember, we're forcing the thing to work. This is not good design, but we're forcing it to work this way. That 122 feet of head, ladies and gentlemen, has to be there to offset what? To offset the pressure drop in the pressure reducing valve. Remember that PLV valve, we dropped 50 pounds through it? We got to put the head back somewhere or it's not going to flow. So we had to make sure we had enough head to offset that. So the problem is we've got a recirc pump trying to recirculate across the pressure reducing valve, and that's going to be an issue. You're going to have to put a very high head, low flow pump in there, or you're going to have to design it differently to make it work. So in summary, here's another little snapshot of the problem. And you see that PRV valve up there, and we're trying to recirc across a PRV valve, and that's trouble. You could make it work with a very high head, low flow pump, which is going to be an energy hog. We can force it to work, but I think there's a better way to get there. So maybe a good solution, which all high-rise buildings do in some form or fashion, is two water heaters, is two recirc pumps, two pressure zones with cold water going to make up, and you got a pressure reducing valve, but that pressure reducing valve is on all the water before it gets there. So that pressure reducing valve is reducing the pressure to the low zone, and I got a low level water heater for the bottom 10 floors with the recirc pump going around and around and around, and notice it does not flow across the PRV. Notice it does not flow across the pressure reducing valve. Now I've got a high level water heater and another recirc pump for the top 10 floors. And as you see, it goes through that water heater to the top, all the way back down, round and around, and that second recirc pump never crosses a pressure reducing valve. And that's how all high rise buildings are done, and I think you see that kind of solves the problem. So here's another good selection, not going too detailed on all this. Different pressure zones for every 7 to 8 stories is what you're going to wind up with. That's what you got to do. What's the moral to the story? Never have a recirc pump cross a pressure reducing valve. If you're going to do that, you're going to have to add the pressure drop back across a pressure reducing valve into your recirc pump. And in my case, I just showed you I had to have 122 feet ahead on a 6 GPM pump to make it work. So just typical examples of high-rise buildings that we will not take our time to go through every one of them, but these are typical examples of how you make it work with recirc pumps. And here's a good job in Charlotte the same way, but you see the pressure reducing valves, particular job in Charlotte. The very bottom you see a water heater and a recirc pump. It does not cross the pressure reducing valve. The pressure reducing valve reduces the water pressure to that zone, to that pressure zone. That pressure zone has a little water heater and goes round and around and around. Another example of one with a brazed plate heat exchanger. And you know what a brazed plate is instead of a water heater. And it shows a piping diagram on that one as well. And then we see one with multiple pressure boosters, one for cold and one for hot, another approach. But what we see in most situations is this last picture I want to show you. This is a typical high-rise building. And what I want to get across, this is a very, very high-rise building. Your max pressure to a fixture is 80 pounds. You probably don't want to put that to a shower. Your minimum pressure to make a water tank work is, what, 20 pounds? To make a flush valve work, what, 25 or 30 pounds? So you're hung in a high-rise building between 25 and 30 pounds to a max of 80 pounds on any fixture. So what they do in a high-rise building is they create pressure zones. Every 6, 7, 8 floors, stories, they have a different pressure zone all the way to the top. And there's several different ways to get there, but most people will put a water heater for every 6, 7, 8 floors with a pressure-reducing valve and a separate recirc pump for each pressure zone, so you don't recirc across a PRV valve. If you're not going to do that, then your recirc pump has to be high head, low flow, to force recirculation across the pressure-reducing valve. More to the story is, if you're doing a high-rise building over 6, 7, 8 floors, remember this seminar. remember talking about it, slow down, remember that slogan, never let domestic hot water go across, recirculate across the pressure reducing valve and stay out of trouble. This is one of the biggest pitfalls we see, and the primary reason is most designers don't deal with high-rise buildings that often, so it kind of catches them off guard.